On my left, weighing in at 3.3 pounds, is the defending 2-in-1 convertible laptop champion, the Lenovo Flex 5. And on my right, weighing in at 3.5 pounds, is the new challenger, the Dell Inspiron 5406. Welcome to the 2021 Ultimate 2-in-1 Convertible Touchscreen Laptop Showdown. So in this video, I will put both these laptops through a 5-round knockout match. So who will be crowned the champion and who goes home the loser? Let's find out. By the way, I've already reviewed both these laptops here on this channel, so you can find links to these reviews in the video description below. Also, if you are interested in finding the latest pricing and availability information about these laptops, please check out country-specific links that I have put in the video description below. So guys, without further ado, let's get started. Lenovo Flex 5's top half is made from aluminium, while the bottom half is built using a 30% fiberglass reinforced polycarbonate. Dell Inspiron's top lid, along with the entire keyboard base and the palm rest area, is also made from aluminium, while the lower body is made from injection molded polycarbonate. In terms of structural integrity, both these laptops feel very strong and resistant to flex. Both these laptops are using high quality metallic hinges that transform them from a traditional clamshell device to a tablet and anything in between. Both laptops use an island style backlit enabled keyboard that offers decent key travel and a satisfying clicky feedback during typing. Both laptops come with a fingerprint sensor for passwordless login. Now Dell has integrated the fingerprint sensor into the power button, which I prefer over Lenovo Flex 5's implementation where it resides under the arrow keys. I also prefer the larger 4.5 by 2.5 inch trackpad on the Dell Inspiron 5406 compared to the 4.2 by 3 inch trackpad that is found on the Lenovo Flex 5. Now when it comes to styling, I dig the Titan Gray sand blasted metallic finish on the Dell laptop. It feels more premium than the platinum gray finish on Lenovo Flex 5, which uses an anodized aluminium stamping. Now guys, this is a personal opinion. I'm sure some of you guys will prefer the look of Lenovo Flex 5 over Dell Inspiron, and that's fine. So this is a very close round, but I will go with Dell Inspiron and declare it the winner of this round. It just feels more solid and refined in my hands. I really appreciate how the palm rest and the keyboard deck feels really nice while typing, and I love its trackpad. So Dell takes this round and it leads the contest 1-0 after round 1. Both Lenovo Flex 5 and Dell Inspiron 5406 have a 14-inch Full HD touchscreen display that supports Active Stylus Pen. Both these displays are using an LED backlit IPS panel that delivers around 250 nits of brightness. Dell's display has a warmer tone compared to Lenovo Flex 5, although both laptops offer software utility to calibrate the color temperature to your liking. Now, both these laptops use a glossy panel, which is great for watching movies, streaming videos, and looking at pictures, but they suffer from glares and reflections when working in a bright lit room. Dell Inspiron 5406 uses Entrig Screen Digitizer, which is the same tech that Microsoft uses in their Surface Pro devices. Lenovo Flex 5, on the other hand, is using an active electrostatic digitizer technology from Wacom. Now, unfortunately, both these technologies are incompatible with each other, so that means you can't use pen from one tablet on the other. So the Dell and the Lenovo Active Pens, they are not compatible with each other. I like the fact that Lenovo Flex 5 includes an active stylus pen with the laptop. Unfortunately, the Dell Inspiron 5406 does not include a pen, and I think that really sucks. So you will have to shell out extra money to buy either Dell's official Active Stylus Pen or a compatible third-party pen. By the way, I have linked these pens in the video description below. So I've extensively used both these laptops for note-taking and also for sketching and making digital art. They both offer good accuracy, latency, and palm rejection. Also, both pens offer various levels of pressure sensitivity, which coupled with low screen latency results in a great note-taking experience. But personally, guys, I prefer Lenovo's note-taking experience over Dell, and it's largely because I get better palm rejection on the Lenovo Flex 5. So again, this is a close round, but I'm going to award this round to Lenovo Flex 5. And after round 2, the scores are now tied at 1-1. When it comes to CPU choice, Dell Inspiron 5406 restricts you to the 11th generation Intel CPUs. Lenovo Flex 5, on the other hand, comes in both 11th generation Intel as well as the Ryzen 4000 series mobile CPUs. So here is a chart showing the key difference between these CPUs. The biggest difference is in the core count. So Intel Core i5 and the Core i7 processors are quad-core CPUs, while the AMD Ryzen 5 and the Ryzen 7 are 6-core and 8-core CPUs. But Intel chips offer something called hyper-threading, which doubles the number of threads, and this feature is disabled in the Ryzen mobile processors. So that means the Intel Core i5 and Core i7 CPUs have 8 threads as opposed to only 6 threads in the Ryzen 5 model and 8 threads in the Ryzen 7 model. So how does all this translate into real world performance? So let's take a look at the Cinebench single core benchmark. So in this benchmark, Intel chips are clearly the winner. Both the Core i5 and the Core i7 are easily beating AMD Ryzen 7 and Ryzen 5 processors. But things look a little different when you look at the Cinebench multi-core benchmark. Here, the 8-core Ryzen 7 4700U comes out on the top, but the 4-core Intel Core i5 and Core i7 processors, they still manage to beat the 6-core Ryzen 5 processors thanks to the hyper-threading. Next, let's look at the graphics performance of the Intel and the AMD chips. So in the iGPU FP32 benchmark, Intel's Iris Xe integrated graphics, it easily beats out AMD's integrated Vega graphics. So the bottom line is that Intel's 11th generation chips are definitely better than Ryzen 4000 mobile processors in both the CPU and the GPU performance. But since Lenovo Flex 5 is offering both Intel and AMD models, I will have to award this round to Lenovo. So after round 3, Lenovo takes a 2-1 lead over Dell. Both laptops come with a 720p webcam that offers around 85 degrees field of view. Now, it's fine for a Zoom conference calls, but if you want to step up the quality of your videos, guys, I will recommend picking an external 1080p USB webcam. You don't have to buy an ultra expensive external webcam. Even the budget webcams will deliver much better quality than, you know, what these laptops offer. So I have linked some of my favorite 1080p webcams in the video description below, and you guys can check it out. Now let's quickly talk about the ports. So both these laptops are offering two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports. They are offering an HDMI port, you get Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.1, and you also get a full-size SD card reader. Both laptops include one USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C port, but the similarity ends here. Dell laptop supports display, data, and power delivery via USB Type-C port, while Lenovo Flex 5 only supports data and power delivery. So that means you can connect Dell Inspiron 5406 to two external monitors at the same time using both the HDMI and USB Type-C port, something that you cannot do in Lenovo Flex 5. Lack of display over USB Type-C also means that you cannot use a USB Type-C hub to connect all your peripheral devices and an external monitor to Lenovo Flex 5 using a single cable. And this is a major drawback, especially if you plan to use this laptop for like working from home and when you want to connect it to your monitor and all the peripheral devices and have a clean workstation. Dell will be a better laptop, you know, for accomplishing this. So this round goes to Dell, and Dell makes a roaring comeback, and now the scores are tied at 2-2 after round 4. Lenovo Flex 5 ships with a beefy 3-cell 52.5 watt-hour battery, while Dell Inspiron 5406 comes with a smaller 40 watt-hour battery. So it's no surprise that Lenovo Flex 5 delivers a longer battery life. I got about 6 hours of battery life doing typical web browsing on Dell Inspiron 5406, while the Lenovo Flex 5 delivered close to 8 hours of battery life. Lenovo also includes a beefier 65 watt USB Type-C charger, which juices up this laptop from 0 to 80% in about an hour. Dell, on the other hand, ships with a smaller 45 watt old school barrel port charger that takes much longer to charge the laptop. Now, regarding thermal heat dissipation, Lenovo Flex 5 is using one large cooling fan and a dual pipe heat sink mechanism to keep the CPU and the GPU cool. In my testing, the Intel version of Lenovo Flex 5, which is Lenovo Flex 5i, it ran noticeably cooler than the 8-core Ryzen 7 4700U model of this laptop. Dell Inspiron 5406, on the other hand, it runs cool, and even the Core i7 model running at full load never throttled, and it always ran above the base clock frequency. So guys, this is going to be a tough round to judge. While the Intel model of Lenovo Flex 5 runs cool, its Ryzen 7 model tends to run hot. Dell, on the other hand, does not offer a Ryzen configuration, but their 11th gen Intel model runs cool. So I think in the end, it will all come down to the battery life. Since Lenovo is offering a 23% larger battery capacity along with a 65-watt USB Type-C fast charger, I think it narrowly beats Dell and takes this round. So guys, the final score is 3-2 in favor of Lenovo Flex 5. Now, Dell Inspiron 5406 put up a really spirited fight, but in the end, it fell short and failed to dethrone the reigning champion, Lenovo Flex 5. So which laptop would you guys have declared the winner of this contest? Let me know in the comment section below and please explain why you think I am wrong and you guys are right. By the way, I have put country-specific links for both Lenovo Flex 5 and Dell Inspiron 5406 in the video description below. So please click on these links to get the latest price and availability of both these laptops in your region. Guys, if you found this video useful, please smash the like button. It encourages the YouTube algorithm to recommend this video and that helps this channel grow. Also, check out technobandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, and other gadgets. So guys, thanks for watching this video and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye!